We want to use the disk method to find the volume of the solid obtained by rotating the region in the first quadrant bounded by the curves x equals 0, y equals 1, and x equals y to the sixth about the line y equals 1. First, notice how we're given this equation here that solve for x, not y. Let's go ahead and solve it for y, so we have a function of x. So if we have x equals y to the sixth, if we want to solve this for y, we could take the sixth root of both sides of the equation, or raise both sides to the 1/6 power. Notice how this would give us the equation y equals x to the 1/6, which is graphed here in blue below. So the region that we're rotating about the line y equals 1 is this region here. Whenever using the disk method to find volume, it's helpful to sketch a rectangle that when rotated about the line of rotation would give us one disk or one circular cylinder that would be the approximate volume of one slice of our solid. So let's say we use this rectangle here. If we were to rotate this rectangle about the line y equals 1, it would give us one disk of our solid, maybe somewhere in here, where the volume of this disk would represent the approximate volume of one slice of our solid. The actual volume of this one disk, a right circular cylinder, would be V equals pi r squared times h, which we see in the integral that gives us the actual volume. Here's the pi. R of x squared is the radius squared, and dx represents the height of each disk or right circular cylinder. So looking at our rectangle, here's delta x, the width of the rectangle. R of x, the radius, would be this distance here. We have to be careful when finding this distance. It's not equal to the function value. It would actually be this distance here, which is 1, and then minus the function value, which would be minus f of x, or in this case, minus x to the 1/6. So in this case, r of x would be 1 minus x to the 1/6. And now we have all the information we need to find our volume. The volume is equal to pi times the integral of r of x squared, which would be the quantity 1 minus x to the 1/6 power squared, integrated with respect to x from 0 to 1. Let's evaluate this on the next slide. Let's begin by squaring the quantity 1 minus x to the 1/6. So we'd have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we have 1 times 1 is 1. Then we have minus x to the 1/6, and then minus another x to the 1/6, so we have minus 2x to the 1/6, and then negative x to the 1/6 times negative x to the 1/6 would be plus x to the, we add the exponents, 1/6 plus 1/6 is 2/6, or 1/3. So we have pi times the integral of 1 minus 2x to the 1/6 plus x to the 1/3, integrate with respect to x from 0 to 1. Now we'll find the antiderivative using the power rule of integration given here. Of pi times the antiderivative of 1 is x minus 2 times the antiderivative of x to the 1/6. So we'll add 1 to 1/6, that's 7/6. So we have x to the 7/6 divided by 7/6 plus the antiderivative of x to the 1/3. 1/3 plus 1 is 4/3. So we have x to the 4/3 divided by 4/3. Let's simplify this. We have pi times x minus, dividing by 7/6 is the same as multiplying by 6/7. So we have 2 times 6/7 x to the 7/6, and then plus, dividing by 4/3 is the same as multiplying by 3/4. So we have 3/4 x to the 4/3. Let's simplify one more time. So we have x minus, this would be 12 sevenths. And now we'll substitute 1, then 0, then find the difference. So when x is 1, we'd have 1 minus 1 to the 7th 6th is still 1, so we have minus 12 sevenths. 1 to the 4 thirds is 1, so we have plus 3 fourths. And then notice when x is 0, all these terms would be 0. So we have pi times this quantity here. Notice how the least common denominator would be 28. 1 is the same as 28 28ths. Multiply 12 sevenths by 4 over 4, that'd be minus 48 28ths. Plus, multiply 3 fourths by 7 over 7, so we have plus 21 28ths. Which gives us pi times, we have 49 28ths minus 48 28ths, that's 1 28th. So the exact volume would be pi divided by 28 cubic units. Let's also get our decimal approximation. Pi divided by 28 comes out to approximately 0.1122. I hope you found this helpful.